Today I am presenting an analogy between the Bio Savart's law and the stream flow of water. Actually, in India, there are many spiritual cities across the holy rivers. Like we know that Haridwar, Varanasi, sometimes it is called Banaras, Nasik, Ujjain, Patna, Ayodhya and Mathura. There are so many spiritual cities across the holy rivers. So the purpose of this lecture is to just develop an analogy between the Bio Savart's law, which basically was developed in 1820 by the Jean Baptiste Biot and Felix Savart in France. So the purpose, as I said here and I'm repeating again, is just to develop an analogy between the Bio Savart law and the stream flow of water, which we basically observe early in the morning. And as I said, that maximum spiritual cities in India are across the holy rivers. So in the first case, I will just describe the Bio Savart's law, which is basically explain about the magnetic field at some distance from the current carrying conductor. If I provide some current to this conductor, which is A to B, this is the length, total length I can say here, L, I current is flowing. So because of a small segment of this wire, that is vector DL, so how much magnetic field will produce? So that magnetic field strength at this P point, which is at R distance away from this vector DL. So there are two points. One is that there is a current carrying conductor in which steady state current is flowing, and because of that I have to find out a magnetic field at a certain distance at a fixed point. So that point is P, and the magnetic field where I have to find out the magnetic field, so that will be dB. Why I am writing in fractional form, in differential form, because this is the result of this small segment, and that is dL. I am writing here vector dL because one knows that length is a scalar quantity, but after that we are writing it is vector dL. So vector dL means that I am considering this vector along the length of this wire, and theta is the angle in between the wire and this point, that this distance. So the magnitude of the field which is produced by this wire in which I current, that is the steady state current, is flowing will be dB, and in terms of magnitude dB will be directly proportional to the current which is flowing into this wire and also to the length of the wire here dL. Third point is sine of this angle, sine theta, and inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So these are the four parameters which I have considered here according to the Bio Savart's law, that magnetic field is directly proportional to the strength of the current, magnetic field at this point is directly proportional to the length of this segment, and directly proportional to the sine of this angle if theta is increasing or theta is decreasing. and inversely proportional to this distance, a square of this distance. Distance between the point where we find out the magnetic field and this length segment, vector dl. So these are four points. When I join these four points, so I found that dB is directly proportional to I dl sin theta upon r square. So further I can write here that dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi, that is a proportionality constant, I dl sin theta upon r square. Right now this formula which I have developed here is in terms of the magnitude, but magnetic field have direction, so the direction of this direction of the magnetic field at this particular point P one can find out using the right hand rule. So if suppose this is the wire and the cap of this marker indicate the direction of current, so by using this right hand rule one can define the direction of the magnetic field. This is the direction of current and this one is the direction of the magnetic field. So magnetic field will be in a circular form, you can say, and the direction will be this side to this side. If this is the plane, so I can say the magnetic field lines are entering into this one. So by this one can say that magnetic field is perpendicular to the plane. So for that I can use the cross symbol, that is this one. It means that magnetic field is inward direction, and here at this point, at anywhere in the left hand side, the magnetic field will be outward. So there are two things, that in the right hand side of this wire in which string current is flowing, the magnetic field direction is inward, and in the left hand side the direction of the magnetic field is outward. So these are two important points which I have to use in the next section of this presentation, where I will describe that why the stream flow of water is important. But before that I am just trying to explain the basic concept of this Biot-Savart's law, where you are observing the magnetic field because of this small segment, not because of the full wire. Right. Consider the small segment, that is vector dl, and this vector, because of this vector dl the magnetic field will be dB, and this dB is directly proportional to this vector which I have already mentioned. And now the formula to calculate the magnetic field at this particular point is dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi, where mu naught upon 4 pi is a proportionality constant. Mu naught is the permeability which defines that how many magnetic field lines can passes through the medium. I dl sin theta upon r square. So this is the magnitude. This formula is in terms of the magnitude. One can write this formula in terms of the vectorial form also. So if I write this formula in terms of vector, then it can be written as vector dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I dl cross unit vector r upon r square. Because I have considered here cross product between this vector dl and this r, so that becomes dl r sin theta. Right now this is unit vector r, and we know that unit vector r is equal to, that defines the direction basically of this distance. Unit vector r defines the direction along this axis. So unit vector r is equal to vector r upon magnitude of this vector r. So now instead of this r, one can write this vector r and the magnitude of this vector. So further, I can write this dB in terms of vector is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I, that is the current dl cross vector r. Now unit vector, earlier we have written here unit vector r, the magnitude of the unit vector r is equal to 1. So further, this unit vector r can be defined in terms of the vector and the magnitude. So I'm just putting the value of unit vector r, so it becomes I dl cross r, where dl is the small segment of the wire, that is element, and represented in terms of the vector dl cross r. Vector r is this vector, that is the distance between this segment of the wire and this point, upon magnitude r. This was the r square and this r becomes r cube. So now this is the vector r, vector, so vector dB. Vector dB is equal to this one. So we have solved basically just find out the magnetic field by using this stream flow of the current. And here I have just used only two points. One is the stream flow of current, that is the steady state current, and second is the direction of the magnetic field. In the right hand side, that is inward, and in left hand side, that is outward direction. This is inward direction and this side outward direction. As I said earlier, that in India maximum spiritual cities are situated across the holy rivers, and all of them maximum cities are on right bank of the rivers, except to the some cases in case of Banaras. But there is some research by observation that Ganga river basically migrated their path, and right now the Banaras city is on the left side of this river. But that is not most important point here. Point is only that the stream flow of the water and the city and the people in the city. So this was the scientifically this was the bio Savartla, and by using this one can find out the magnetic field at any point P. This magnetic field strength will be stronger near to the wire, and this formula indicates it depends inversely proportional to the to the R. So if R increases, so dB will decrease, like this. So the magnetic field will be stronger near to the wire as compared to the larger distance. So this was the point only, and now I'm coming on my analogy with this where one is calculating the magnetic field by using the stream flow of the current. And on the same pattern, Ampere's law, by using the Ampere's law, in the same way, this is a current carrying conductor in which I current is flowing, produce a magnetic field, and one can find out the magnetic field at this point, that is P. So if we draw a closed path, so I can find out the magnetic field here. So if suppose this distance is R and the magnetic field produced here is B, so the direction of the magnetic field will be again this one, as I shown this path. So the magnetic field basically is tangential at every point on this path. So the Ampere's law says the closed path integral of this magnetic field B dot dl, which is result of this current, is equal to the mu naught times the current which is enclosed by this closed loop. This is the condition. So there are two similarities in between these two laws, that a uniform current is flowing into the conductor and as a result magnetic field is producing. So one can find out that magnetic field by this law also. If r is the radial distance, so b dot dl, because b is constant at every point, so b comes out, and this is dl is equal to mu naught times that current which is enclosed here. So dl means that closed path circumference. So b, I am writing here b into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught times I enclosed. So one can find out the magnetic field strength at any point. So b is equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I that enclosed upon r. So by this way one can find out the magnetic field. So one thing is coming from these two laws, which is very well known in physics community, that the stream flow of the current producing the magnetic field. So when I use this analogy into the case of river, where water is flowing in a stream without any disturbance, and that situation is basically we observed in early in the morning. So I am taking this lecture in the case of little bit towards the spiritual side. So I am saying that now the second part of this presentation, where I am just trying to correlate the Vyosa, our concept, with this situation, where this is the river in which water is flowing . The water flows stream, there is no disturbance, and this situation we find early in the morning, there is no disturbance into the water, that is almost stream flow of the water, like the current in case of Biot-Savart law we have seen, or in Ampere's law. So in both these situations, this kind of situation is almost same. So there is no turbulent flow of the water, this is a stream flow of water, and this flow of water we observe early in the morning. So now a person is sitting across the river. This is the situation. Now what will happen? Why the Indian marriage is basically develop all the spiritual cities across the river, and why they prefer yoga and meditation early in the morning near about to the river bank? This is the region. This distance basically from the river. The flow of water in this direction. Man is sitting on the right side, right bank of the river. So what will happen? Here, thus again, you can say that the nature of this body is have almost of 3/2 part of the water. This is also water. So stream flow of water produce a kind of field, and the direction of field is inward, this side, and the body basically have water molecule, and water molecule are in polar form. Those have positive and negative charges. So I am not sure that it will happen, but by analogy I am just trying to explain that these polarity of these water molecules becomes polarized because of this effect, because of this field. So the possibility is what? Possibility is this one. So early in the morning, when there is a uniform flow of the water, what happens? A kind of field develops. I'm not saying that is magnetic field or electric field. I'm just saying that because of like in current, magnetic field is developing. So a stream flow of the water will produce a field, and the water and the body have the same nature. The body contains water molecules, so that field basically can polarize the water molecules, and because of that electric polarization inside the body can create the high electric field. And because of that high electric field, one man can go in a higher state of the consciousness. I am in the primary stage of this study, but I personally feel that there is a scope of study here on the analogy of this Biosavartla. So in our Maharishi, our yogis basically prefer to do yoga and meditation early in the morning near to the river bank. Why they develop the spiritual cities across the river. So there might be some physical phenomenon. Those everything, whatever they did in their past, they develop everything scientifically. And this Biosavartla developed in 1820. And our spiritual cities are developed before that. So personally, I'm not against to any field, but I'm saying that there is a kind of field which which can bring the change in the body scientifically, and as a result, that basically brings creativity into the person. So that field is so effective, and I think because of that our yoga guru and spiritual gurus prefer yoga and meditation early in the morning. So this is just an analogy, and this can be may be a reason. You can say that either this Biosavartla develop by using this analogy, or one can say right now that again using this Biosavartla one can define such kind of field, because before Biosavartla the astronomy was so strong in the strong in the India, and every spiritual places are situated very carefully. So the role of astronomy and the role of spirituality is combined. So there is a possibility that such kind of effects appear in the morning when the water flow becomes a stream, and that basically produce the electric polarization into the body, and because of that electric polarization a potential difference create inside the body, and the current basically flow into the body, and that basically bring consciousness and other spiritual effect into the physical body. So this is just only an analogy. I'm not saying that this will be happen, but this there is a possibility because of this reason. So thanks for watching this presentation. Your remarks, your comments are important for me, but this was just an analogy, just to search something from the old tradition in India, which develops very scientifically. Thanks for watching this video.